Hi, my name is Jake Newsome, and I work at the Mandel Center for Advanced Holocaust Studies at the U.S. Holocaust Memorial Museum in Washington, D.C. And so I will be giving tonight's lecture here at Temple Isaiah on the Nazi persecution of gays and lesbians during the Holocaust. So my lecture will be about the Nazis' campaign against homosexuality and why they thought that understanding and controlling human sexuality was a vital part of their quest to forge, you know, a master race. And so I'm going to look at some of the gay and lesbian victims, tell their stories, but also shed some light on the post-war situation of these victims and how they were remembered or not remembered, as was often the case, as victims of the Holocaust. This topic is incredibly important. It's relevant in today's political situation, but also the history itself, I think, is more than just a history of a particular minority group. I think that the lessons that it has to teach us are about the importance of recognizing, but then also safeguarding the rights of minorities in society. And so really it teaches us about the fragility of democracy and human rights in a modern, you know, diverse society. You know, I think that it's particularly relevant today, given what's going on in Chechnya. You know, there are reports coming out of Chechnya that the government is implementing these really harsh discriminatory, you know, measures against gay people there in Chechnya. Even some reports that they are having like some types of internment camps for them. And so being able to look back at this history, I think, as a lesson is obviously still important today. Well, one thing that I hope that people get out of the lecture is just a sense of who these victims were. A lot of times, you know, gays and lesbians are considered one of the, you know, so-called forgotten victim groups of the Nazi regime. And so I hope that through my lecture tonight, people will just be able to understand that these were, you know, real people, that they had stories, that they had lives, they were someone's mother or father or, you know, brother. And so I hope that they were just able to make that connection with them, you know, as fellow human beings.